When Kaye and I first got married, we thought it would be fun for me to be the provider at the beginning and for her to be the one that would provide all the nurturing to our kids. But then we thought, well, maybe we'll flip that around after 10 years or 20 years and switch roles. The second part of that never worked out because I was able to make so much more than what she could have made as a practicing attorney, which was probably a good thing. Katie was such a magnificent nurturer.
I think I'm the most blessed person on the planet to have been able to bear children the way I have.
She was blessed with an endless amount of energy. She really cared about our kids.
God knew me, and I knew that He had a plan for me. And so when children came along, I really felt like I was His partner. And it wasn't easy. It was really hard, and I wasn't good at it. I got sick every time.
But she was also a master of distraction. And she would even tell our kids that when they asked, you know, how can I be a better parent? She said, well, don't you remember? You know, it's really important that you be able to distract little kids all the time. Because sometimes they'll be doing something that you don't want them to be doing, or they'll be getting upset and starting to cry or yell. If you can redirect all of that energy into something productive, then you've instantly solved two problems. You have them now doing something productive, and you have them not sulking or crying or going on and on.
And I just want to say to all of our children and grandchildren that are listening, what a privilege it has been to be part of your lives.
I really appreciate that they let us figure things out on our own and kind of become who we are, be who we are.
In September, we'd start reading the Book of Mormon and we'd finish in June. And then we'd do something else in the summer. Both my dad and mom, God and the scriptures, very important to them.
I remember one time a magazine from our town came and interviewed my family because we were so different and so weird, and they just couldn't believe that a suburban Los Angeles family really had 10 kids. And the IRS also didn't believe that we had 10 kids and audited my dad one time for taking all these tax deductions, and they found out, yep, it's real.
Even though I was the fourth, I never felt overlooked or like I got lost in as one of many children. I felt like my mother knew me personally, my father too, for that matter.
I got really into drawing when I was in middle school, and then I got really into music. And my mom was always my biggest champion in that regard. It's also her ability to see each of her 10 children as an individual with individual interests and not just a mold that they need to fit.
It's totally normal for me, though. I don't know any different. I love it. In fact, I love it so much. I found a wife who is the eighth in 8 children of her family, and I'm the 8th out of 10. And so at her house, it's the same thing. It's just big family, and all of her siblings are having kids too.
I know that if we ever asked my mom or my dad a question like, oh, can I go to the movies or whatever, they wouldn't say, oh, go ask your dad, because they were on the same page.
It's been a very interesting journey marrying a convert, because I see things through a different lens, with Guy not having grown up in the gospel. And also, I see a wonderful human being who has far exceeded my knowledge in terms of gospel.
We have had a wonderful, beautiful, fulfilling satisfying marriage and family life. The secret has been, the focus has always been the Savior, Jesus Christ, our Heavenly Father and the Holy Ghost. And whenever it seems like we've experienced any challenges, it's been because we lost that focus. When we've listened, when we've done what the Spirit directed, only good things have happened.
My greatest hope for you is to develop a relationship with the Savior and with Heavenly Father, knowing that we're here on this earth for just a short time, and we want so desperately to get back to be with Him as a family. So my plea and my desperate hope is that you will focus on Him and you will always learn everything that you can to become closer to Him. Just get the world out of your way and clear your mind and let Him speak to you. Another enhancing way that I have learned that God speaks to me and loves me is when I take time to be quiet and listen. And I hope that you will never lose sight of the fact that you are loved by Heavenly Father and His Son, Jesus Christ, and how much the Savior suffered for all of you and for me. And what a glorious, glorious plan it is for us to be part of this world. And no matter what pain we go through and what confusion we might have, if we just go back to that source, we will be led and we will be assured of His great love for us.
Brittany and Clark and Aaron and Casey and Mara and Nicole, Scott, Tanner, Tori and Whitney, we love you with all of our hearts. We pray for you every night when we go to bed and in the morning. We pray for your success. We pray that your testimonies will grow every day. We love your spouses. We love our 23 grandchildren. We love all of the grandchildren not yet born. And to each of you, we look forward to meeting you, hopefully in this earth life. We just want you to know that even when we're gone, we're going to be on the other side. If the Lord will permit us, we will be around you all the time. And we will come and visit you, and we will rejoice when you have happy times. We will cry with you when you have hard times. And we will embrace you, if the Lord will let us, in those hard moments and in those joyous times. It's my personal hope and desire that when each of you steps across, that He'll let us be there. And I would love to be the very first face that you see when you step across the veil. What a wonderful time that will be, that future date. Make it a point. Be there. Do the things that you need to do. Put your children not in harm's way, but put them in the Spirit's way so that they can experience those warm and peaceful feelings inside so that they can have revelation. So that their relationship can cement with the Savior, and it will do away with so many of the problems that you might otherwise have with parenting if your children have a relationship with God and feel comfortable in that relationship. Our dream, our vision, is to have all 10 of our kids, their spouses, and all of our grandkids together in one great big circle, happy embrace. And to have the Savior in the center of that circle, with Heavenly Father and the Holy Ghost all present there. That's our vision. That's our dream. You want to add anything else, Mama?
You just painted a beautiful picture, one that we have visualized our whole lives.
We love you.
We love you.